Just leave me for somebody else. Enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself. Just leave me for somebody else. Enjoy yourself, enjoy yourself.
Hello. Just wanted to apologize for this being so short. I wanted to get something out, since it's been 2 weeks since I've uploaded. I'm currently working on editing my R, so prepare for a bit of angst. Anyways, enjoy and thanks for 100 subs. Yamaguchi's POV. It was the usual day after practice, or mostly normal. Atsuki seemed to be a little bit, how should I put it, saltier. There was something bothering him, but I didn't look into it since it's Tsuki. He's not the type to share what's bothering him. We made our way past the school gates after practice. Being a pinch server, I didn't do much, but I did still practice. I was rambling on as usual, and I didn't see the particular aura surrounding Tsuki before it was too late, to say the least. Do you ever shut up? I stopped. I mean, yeah, he tells me to shut up all the time, but it usually has no bite behind it, but this time it was different. I stayed quiet, not knowing what to say. Seriously, now you stay quiet? Honestly, you're so fucking annoying. Stop following me around like a lost puppy, and go do something useful for once in your life. Maybe then your mom would love you. Tears started to form. Everything around me suddenly went dark, as if nothing existed. Honestly, you're pathetic, thinking that you're useful. TCH, I can't believe I ever thought of you as a friend. What a joke. I opened my mouth to say something, anything, but nothing came out. It's as if I had no voice. The feelings in my chest were painful. So this is what it feels like when you're betrayed, I thought to myself. This feeling of emptiness, the pain of not feeling good enough. Before I realized it, my legs moved. They ran nowhere in particular, just wanting to get away from the glare that was disappointment, hatred. Before I realized it, I found myself in a path. I've been here a few times, and not many people walked past, since it was mostly abandoned, so I decided it was the perfect place to rest. I sat down near one of the tree trunks and it all just came out. The tears I was trying so hard to stop just suddenly boiled out with no sign of stopping. You're pathetic. That sentence repeated in my mind over and over again, before I drifted to sleep.